get a sheet. Please be seated. Thank you. Okay, the next speaker this morning is Teddy Liho. He is from the Academy of Sofia in Bulgaria. And it will be interesting to hear his view on innovation in the arts. So, Teddy, are you ready? You are ready? Okay, give Teddy a big hand.
Thank you, Lynn, for presentation. Thank you for everybody being here. I would like to share with you my more than 20 years experience in one leg in the digital and first leg in analog at environment in the field of art. So I put a bit strange title to my presentation in front of you. It's how to transform the lemon. Because in the early 80s, when the Apple new brand appeared, in my circle, we were students at that time, and we asked very joyful, why they put this strange fruit for the logo of the brand new company, Apple. And some of my teachers, which are very strange of humor, and I like it very much, he explained, and because they have a lemon in their hands. So at this time, the lemon, it's a symbol to me, some very specific one, and you can play with that. So transform the lemon into lemonade. And in our days, it's very tricky and very exciting to explore possibilities which new technologies and communication channel to give us chance to share and to promote our field of work. So possibilities are almost endless. So this is a question of changes. So in the early 80s, it started the big phenomena of digital revolution. At that time, it was not defined in a good way what direction it will be. There is a lot of imagination what the digital era in front of us can be. And there is one main direction which offer the visionaries and technologies offer, but everybody of us has a feeling, his personal feeling about changes in front of us. So some small stuffs would like to be very big one, very colorful, and to share their dreams. But the paradox was that year after year, we have more power computers. When I look in my storage area, and I see my first professional computer platform, and to share a specification of that platform with my students, they don't believe that this computer work very hard graphic work at that time in early 90s and solve a very specific and attractive creative and artistic solutions. But every generation has his own dreams. In our generation, our youngsters, some of them are among us, they are brilliant, and I'm sure that they have their own dreams, and they have special new toolbox for that. But there is a warning message. This message comes from the late 50s. Congratulations. So, many stories start in home size, including Apple's story. I'm sure that many of you knows the story about the Apple. It starts at home, in garage. Many of you knows the story about Adobe. It's home size beginning as well. So let's allow to our cats to dream as well. By the way, the cats give a lot of idea to many artists, and this is one of the creature which is till the end of their evolution path, because they are very playful. This is a reason I like very much cats. So this is one of my basic recommendations and advice to my students and every young people. First of all, invest in your dreams. Digital stories and digital toolbox comes after that. So allow to your dreams lead you. Yeah. How many of you have a clear memories about early 80s among you? Did you remember what our analog, fully analog world was? At that time, the top of the technology was a fax machine. We put in one machine piece of paper on other side from other country, for other city or next door, the same paper, most of them was readable very hard because of thermoprocess during that. And a lot of artists from my generations and even before start to scare what the digital platform, digital possibilities bring to the artistic world. And this scare not belong to the 80s. These scares exist even much more. It was same when the photography was invented. Our colleagues, portrait painters and painters, was very, very scared about new technologies. But in the same hand, many artists recognize photography as a very strong and powerful toolbox for their creativity. So there is two points. This coin have two sides all the time. One is negative, full with scares, and another one is positive if you recognize possibilities of new technologies. So this dilemma is very old, and it depends. You can see there is an artist. So, the first problem or possibility which immediately recognize is that it's not necessary to have Alexandria Library at your home. It is in front of your eyes on the screen. So this is a basic adventure our young generation now has in front of their eyes. And it appears some stereotypes. I think that most of you recognize Rembrandt's Nachtwacht. So there is a pro and anti verso. All of this reflects. So we say this is iPod generation now. But in fact, many of artistic profiles and performances are changed now. Completely changed is the music world. Musicians know that very well. It's a process of recording is fully digitalized. It's increased the quality of sound, of interpretation, recording, and live performances. In the field of photography, there is a Paul Yates, expert in that. He explained in a clear way what's the difference between analog, all astralon films and digital platforms are. There is a debate between photographers as well. And can you give me a kick? What is your field of work? Is it in your field of work changes because of digital technologies as well? I'm sure that in publicity and printing of books and technologies of publishing, there is a big changes as well. So I'm sure that in more, almost in all field of work in the artistic and culture sector, there is a huge changes in a positive way. And there is some special person which blink a red light and explain that there is special moments and tricky moments, the dark side of the moon. Jared Lanier, I suppose most of you knows this guy. He's one of the forerunners of virtual reality. He's one of the first TED speakers in the beginning of 80s. He's a guy which put a lot of efforts and a lot of studies developing technology of virtual reality. There is some of his books dedicated to that subject. Last one is Who Owns the Future? And the key message for him is about social networks. He made that special talk with TED some months ago, just before close his Facebook account, but because of special purpose. He criticized a Facebook company because too much commercials start to appear in that platform. You can see his quotation here. We cannot have a society in which if two people wish to communicate, the only way that can happen if it financed by third person who wishes to manipulate them. So you have to be very, very careful about that. And there is some more facts. There is circle, Thinking Art, which promote and debate about pro and verso digital endless use, and especially for the young generation. And there is some illustrations which quotation from that platform, and after that you can see. That's a brilliant illustration, isn't it? Ladies, he has a very special, elegant proportion of the screen. Special kind of sharks, new kind of sharks appear around. Back to the history. So, if we look for our basic digital dictionary, ask Google, we will discover that digital age is 3 times more popular than a bread. So, back to viewing point, this prehistorian figures. Look at the half-empty glasses as well. They belong to the digital, not digital, analog environment. And it's very basic transformation. The same heroes in our age have other position, you know. They don't need more their physical power. So I'm sure that most of you feel it in one moment of their life like lost in this digital desert or forest. It depends from what kind of season it's around you. But the question is that we lost our criteria or overwhelming with too much information, which is just jumping around us. There is another one guy which I met last year in cantina of Hebrew University in Jerusalem, just some meters next to me on the table, and we spent a very short but very interesting and very attractive talk. And since that time, I read a lot of his books. Actually, there are 3 for the moment, but that's nice. And there is a special talk from him on TED platform, which explained very briefly what the humankind development is. And he explained that digital future of the humankind, of human society, is part of this evolution process, because only to people belongs possibility to collaborate in a large size of numbers. But collaborate flexibly and smartly. What we talk about when we see this warning message about collaboration in social networks. It's Yaron Harari. And when we talk about collaboration in large size and flexible collaboration, and I saw that talk on TED, the same evening, I made some very rough sketches of that image. And some minutes after, I saw the same principle on the TV screen. It was World Championship of Football. So the corporate is possibility of new social platforms. These possibilities is very, very important to all of us. And the feeling that we are part of a large-size community which belongs to the whole world, not only to our local size community. I would like to share with you this very remarkable speech, which was very popular since some months ago.
Young man, why are you eating that fish?
The young man says,
because I love fish.
He says, oh, you love the fish. That's why you took it out of the water and killed it and boiled it. He says, don't tell me you love the fish. You love yourself. And because the fish tastes good to you, therefore you took it out of the water and killed it and boiled it. So much of what is love, right, is fish love, right? And so, young couple falls in love. Young man and young woman fall in love. What does that mean? That means that he saw in this woman someone who he felt could provide him with all of his physical and emotional needs. And she saw in this man somebody she feels that she can write. That was love, right? But each one is looking out for their own needs. Right? It's not love for the other. The other person becomes a vehicle for my gratification. Too much of what is called love is fish love. Right? An external love is not on what I'm going to get, but what I'm going to give. We had an ethicist, Rabbi Dessler, who said, the people make a serious mistake in thinking that you give to those whom you love. And the answer is, the real answer is, you love those to whom you give. Right? And his point is, if I give something to you, I've invested myself in you. Right? And since self-love is a given, everybody loves themselves, now that part of me has become in you, right, there's part of me in you that I love. Right? So true love is a love of giving, not a love of receiving.
So now we have a chance to share our love with huge, huge audience, and we can use it in the right and artistic way. It's very important to share our love with so many people. And probably in a funny way, I don't know, is it see that this is a heart, four colors? Probably many of you knows that platform and this group, which is OK Go. And they're kidding with quite new device. This is electronic and electric power. This one.
Yeah, do this.
I won't let you down, no, I won't let you down. I won't let you down, my love. I won't let you down.
don't seem to mind that much to me. You got what the whole world wants, so strap that armor tighter on. Double on down, like it's gonna make you free. Maybe all you need is someone to trust. Maybe all you need is someone. Maybe all you need is someone to trust. Maybe all you need is someone. I won't let you down, no, I won't let you down. I won't let you down, my love. I won't let you down, no, I won't let you down. I won't let you down, my love.
Last time when we was in the same hall, some years ago, this clip was impossible to make it because of technologies. So it's just in few years we see what fun appears. So, and I would like to share this guy, Christoph Niemann, which is an amazing illustrator, and he has a special talk about combining analog environment with virtual reality. He has special video tutorials about VR at the moment. So strongly recommend his materials. They are available on internet platform. Here is his book. And he described his morning hour like this one. And after that, he start to hunting. He think with ink. And there is a moment to make a bridge with some guy, which I am sure that most of you knows him very well. And I has a pleasure and privilege to meet him here in CA. This is Peter Smith. Which I'm deeply respect because he belongs to the generation with very strong and strong and powerful knowledge of traditional wood prints, traditional Victorian technique for the graphic prints, and in the same time he has open mind and playful. Like a kid, fresh kid mind for new technologies. And some years ago, he shared his experience with touchscreen platform, one software which helps him to create these pictures. And the revolutionary to me for this software which Peter shared with us is that a recording process of drawing. You can see how the artist's every gesture and corrections are. So it's amazing to see that. Thank you. Share with you and some project with Peter shared with us some months ago. It was a new design and new identity of culture institution like a Shakespeare Globe Theater, and Peter is involved in that project. So you can see this one. You can see when one creative idea start to work and it's combined and it's a synergy platform for many toolboxes for the artist from the stage and And there is a just mark about new technologies which are allowed to us and it's just on one hand distance from us. You can test it and try and enjoy it. There is a new platform which Google announced before 2 years. It's a Tilt Brush platform. It's a platform for visual artists which allow them to create a drawing in three-dimensional structures. There is a links with many about workshops, and there is a platform for training courses about that. It's open now. There is a Tilt Brush by Google. And there is announced about art in residence for the young people which have interest to experiment with this completely new field of work. I have a privilege to use twice this platform, and believe me, it's incredible. It's quite old feeling when you draw in front of you, but the shocking moment is when you put your eyes here, and there is endless. You feel in zero coordinate. You start to look in your foot and your top, and you can draw with that. Okay. And there is a lot of possibility in virtual reality and augmented reality in the business promotion field. And I would like to finish with one very short introduction of multimedia performance of company, which name is Sila Sveta, and it's cross between video art and ballet.
16 years ago, you became employee number 7 at SpaceX, and then over the next years, you somehow, you know, built a multi-billion-dollar relationship with NASA, despite the fact that SpaceX's first 3 launches blew up. I mean, how on earth did you do that?
So, actually, selling rockets is all about relationships. And making a connection with these customers. When you don't have a rocket to sell, what's really important is selling your team, selling the business savvy of your CEO. That's not really hard to sell these days. And basically making sure that any technical issue that they have or any concern you can address right away. So it, I think it was helpful for me to be an engineer. I think it was helpful to my role as running sales for Elon.
And currently, a big focus of the company is, I guess, kind of a race with Boeing to be the first to provide the service to NASA of actually putting humans.
Thank you.
With this, I would like to finish my presentation, which I prepared. There is some useful links dedicated to technologies and application of them in the different art fields. And I put my contact list in front of exhibition area, and everybody would like, if you would like to receive the presentation, you can leave your email. And I'm happy to answer to your question if they are with this presentation. Thank you.
Okay, we have time for one question, so it must be an important one. So, who has a question? So, any questions, dear friends? Are you sure? Okay. Then I want to thank Teddy. You get a nice present. To remember us, well, we will always remember you.
Special digital break.
Yes, that's very good.
Thank you.
I like it.
Thank you.
Okay, be sure you get this presentation. Okay, Jill.
Wow, that was quite amazing. Thank you, Teddy. So we're just going to have one interview before we break for lunch. And I'd really like to invite Jolien Damsma to the stage. So Jolien, are you somewhere in the house? Let's give her a hand. Thank you. Hey, welcome. It's good to see you. Yes. Grab the mic. Yeah. Welcome.
Thank you.
So, another younger member of our CA family, and it's really good to see you, and all the way from Holland.
Yes.
Not too far.
So, it was a short trip this year. It was very good compared to the being stuck in traffic last year.
Yeah, absolutely. Great. Well, it's really good to see you here. And 2 years ago, you were one of the first in the Young Talent Contest. Is that right?
Yes,
first to perform.
I performed at the talent evaluation.
Okay.
Then Didi and Ellie, they filmed, they record the performance and showed it to Lean.
Yes.
And thanks to Lean, I got to perform that night.
Fantastic.
On stage.
And your CA journey began.
Yes.
Yeah.
It did.
That's wonderful. And you're performing this year?
I am.
Which night?
Tonight.
Tonight. Okay,
yes.
So we can look forward to seeing a little bit more of you later. So at the moment, you're currently a singer-songwriter, but you're also doing studies. So you're still in your early 20s. And can you just tell us what you're studying at the moment?
At the moment, I'm studying social work. And last year I had an internship with children who have behavioral problems.
Okay.
So I chose to do another study next to singing because in a way it's kind of a safety net for me.
Mm-hmm.
And it gives me the room to create and sing without putting pressure on it.
Okay.
So that's why I chose to.
You chose to do social work, yeah.
But
were there other reasons why you chose that as a sort of subject area as well?
I think I didn't make it very easy for myself, to be honest, because I'm more of an introvert person.
Okay.
And but I have a heart for people and for children. I love children. I work with children now. So, and. I just wanted to develop myself and put myself out of the comfort zone and see how to develop and connect in with other people as well, and how can I give?
Okay.
Like we saw in the movie Teddy yeah. showed.
Yeah.
How do you give
yeah.
the love?
Yeah, how do yep. you connect? Mm-hmm. That's interesting. So that's great. We're interested that you have been thinking about life beyond just being a singer-songwriter, but let's just focus again back on the singer-songwriter mm-hmm. part of your life, because you've been growing very much in that area. Opportunities yep. have been coming along,
yes.
and some very exciting ones mm-hmm. quite recently. Do you want to just share with everybody your introduction to Supertramp?
Yes. Well, it's kind of a long story, but I'll try to tell the short version.
Okay.
I live in a very small village, and Ellie lives in the same village as well. And there are a lot of artistic people around. It's very, yeah, lucky for me
yeah.
to share our arts with each other. And there's a lyric writer who wrote songs for Herman van Veen, who's a Dutch singer. Okay. and performer, and he's in his late 70s, and he had the idea to start a YouTube channel, mm-hmm. and he asked me to sing a song, and we recorded it, and it was very simple, and then someone he knows saw the video, and he wanted mm-hmm. to talk to me, and he turned mm-hmm. out to be an artistic director person who mm-hmm. helps at a production company for... Okay. artists to connect them to venues mm-hmm. and so he wanted to meet me, and we talked, and I told him about who I am, what I do. I sang a couple of songs, and I think it spoke to him.
Okay.
And then because I love 70s music, so he invited me to come and see Roger Hudson in Rotterdam. And that's okay. just a few weeks ago, okay. and to meet him. So that was very exciting.
Yeah, fantastic. Okay, and as a result of that, do you know anything that will come out of that?
It might, but I because he asked me what... at first okay. I thought I was just going to shake hands, you know, just a formal introduction. But okay. then he was eating, and he said, do you want to join us? Do you want to sit next to me? And
yeah.
and that was really amazing. He really took the time to talk with me, okay. and I'm probably gonna record some songs soon.
Okay.
And because I know the person who arranged the concerts, mm-hmm. also for Roger.
Okay.
There's an opportunity to let him hear
what you've done,
what I've done, yeah. what I'm probably gonna record. So
yeah.
Yeah. So that's very exciting, and you never know what happens. But yeah. I would already be so thrilled
yeah.
to hear what he would say about it.
Yeah.
Yeah, and if you would like it.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that's very exciting. And are there any other exciting projects for the future for you?
Yes. I've also been busy this year with a project from Karen Bloemen, okay. who's a famous Dutch singer in Holland. Mm-hmm. And I sang in her show 2 years ago, and then she asked me to join this project. She we're in a group of 9 young people, and they gave us the opportunity to learn about music, about techniques, how to stand on stage, how to perform. Mm-hmm. And the end goal is to perform on the Uitmarkt in Amsterdam. That's the end of the month. That's okay. kind of a big thing
yeah.
as well.
Oh,
yeah.
wonderful. So how do you manage to balance your studying and your musical life? What takes priority?
Yeah, it's quite a challenge sometimes. Yeah. I sometimes say that my study is my hobby and music yes. is who I am, you know.
Okay.
But
yeah.
I think you really have to guard your borders, you know.
Yes.
Because when I don't have a lot of time to sing or to write songs, I get frustrated mm-hmm. because I need to get it out of my system.
Yeah.
And you just, what I do is just take every opportunity that comes along. Mm. It's the same with the Roger Hudson story. It, just because I recorded a simple YouTube video to have fun with someone, mm-hmm. you can't imagine what could come out of it.
Yeah.
So
okay.
I'm just...
Yeah.
And trying things that are scary as
yes.
well.
Yeah.
Because the workshops from Karen Bloemen are in Amsterdam.
Okay.
And I never thought I was... Got to go to Amsterdam every week.
Yeah.
And that was very scary for me at first. But Yeah, that was a step out of the comfort zone as well.
Yeah, but you're managing it.
Yes.
And you've only got two more years of study to go.
Yes.
And then it's a
I'm
question
halfway
of
there.
Yeah, then it's a question of let's see what the next chapter is. Yeah. So what do you think that you have learnt so far from your studies? Let's say from your studies first. What are you learning that you think is quite significant for you at this point?
Well, because I study social work, you mm-hmm. learn how to communicate with people. Mm-hmm. And that in music is so important. Mm-hmm. I saw the same thing with Roger. He's grounded and he puts himself in a vulnerable position. So he's not afraid to show that he's vulnerable mm-hmm. and just like all of us. Mm-hmm. And I think everything I experience and all the difficult things, mm-hmm. I write songs about it and then I can share it. Mm-hmm. And yeah, so mostly communicating with each other.
Okay. So that's
a link
factor.
Between the two. Yeah.
Yeah, that's great. And what do you think that you have learned from Christian artists so far?
So many things.
Okay.
Yeah. But most of all, when I first came here, I was very... I was staying in that comfort zone. There it is again. Mm-hmm. And I was kind of lost, really, because I made a decision to study something just because people said you need to make decisions based on security. You have to earn money. You have to make a living for yourself when you're done, and mm-hmm. just keep the singing as a hobby and don't focus too much on that. Mm-hmm. And so that was a mistake.
Okay.
Because for me, we're only here once. Mm-hmm. And why not take the risk? Mm-hmm. Why not? Why mm-hmm. not sing and so when I got here and the experience of singing on this stage with a band mm-hmm. and singing a song and it came to life and that mm-hmm. feeling of sharing and what I got mm-hmm. back from mm-hmm. everyone else, mm-hmm. that's I can't describe it, but that has been mm-hmm. probably the biggest gift I received ever. Yes.
Fantastic. And you're still here and coming back for more.
Yes.
Which is great. So
I'm addicted now.
Yeah, that's wonderful. Well, thank you ever so much for just sharing your journey to date.
You're welcome.
I just wondered if there are any questions that anyone would like to ask Yolene about how she straddles two parts to her life, or anything that's resonated with any of you that you would like to ask her before we close. I know you've got a hungry head on, but you could do this. Any questions? Yeah, we have one question from Paul. Okay, thank you.
You run so well.
Actually, it's not a question. It's congratulations, because you've learned that... communication is so important, and you're making that connection, you know, you're doing that in two areas of your life. Mm-hmm. Good on you, that's great.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Thank you, Yolene, and thank you, Jill.
You're welcome.
Okay, originally we had here an interview with Maria Marchesini. She was from Greece, but she had to fly home. The reason were the bushfires around Athens. And so her problems were, her family were getting problems with those bushfires. The family is well and doing okay. She asked me yesterday about it, but now she has to take care of her family because this is a very, very awful situation, as you could have seen on TV and in the news. Let me see. Then we go for lunch. And then at 1:30, there is a concerto in the muziekkamer in the castle. And Evert van der Pol is going to play there. And at 2 o'clock, please be back on time. Yeah, 2 o'clock. We'd like to see you here. God bless you. Have a nice lunch.